Okay, this problem is a little tricky, but we could figure it out using the same ideas that we've been talking about so far. We have a plane inclined at an angle of 45 degrees, and it passes through a diameter of the base of a cylinder of radius r. Find a formula for the volume of the region within the cylinder and below the plane. So what we're looking for is the volume of this wedge that we have right here. And we know that the radius of the base is r. And we also know that the angle here is 45 degrees, and we'll see how to use that later. Okay, so what we need to do first off is figure out what our cross section is. So I made a small model here, Plato model. This is supposed to be the wedge. And so this is the round cylinder part, and this is the bottom. This is supposed to be a 45 degree angle. Now, if we take a slice of this, I lost my slicer. My slicer is gone. Hold on a second, let me get my slicer. Okay, I'm back with my slicer. So we're gonna take a cross section. Actually, there's two ways to do this one, but we're gonna take you can take a cross section like this, which would give you triangles, but I'm gonna do this one later on if you feel like trying it and trying the cross sections the other way and comparing, then you can do that for fun because we love calculus and volumes. But if we take a cross section like so, what we end up with is a rectangle. Okay, so let me leave this here for a second. Another thing that we haven't done is we need to put this on the axis. So let's put the center right on the origin. So this is the y-axis, this would be the x-axis. And so we have a rectangle here, and we need to figure out how to find we need the length and the width of the rectangle, or in other words, the base and the height. So this rectangle, I mean, you imagine that it's right here like this. And so let me put down the rectangle, let's say for like if I were to lay it flat. Okay, now let's take a look here. Let's say that this is the x value of where I did a slice. Now notice that the slice is perpendicular to the x-axis. So let me blow this up here. This is going to be from here to here, so this is the origin, and this is going to be x. And notice that the wedge has a 45 degree angle. So that means that if I go up here at a 45 degree angle, well, if the length down here, the base of this triangle is going to be x, then the height also has to be x. Either from remembering your special right triangles or using trig, but the sides of those two I mean, sorry, the sides of the triangle are exactly the same, and this corresponds to the height of the rectangle. So that's this guy right here. So that's from this point up to the top of the wedge. So what we're looking at is the triangle that's formed basically right here. And so this length is x, which means that this one is also x. Now, obviously, my Plato isn't exactly to scale, but that's what we're saying. Since the angle is 45 degrees, then the base of this triangle right here is equal to the height, which is equal to the height of the rectangle, the cross section. Okay, now we also need to find the length of the rectangle. Now this one's a little bit trickier because the length of the rectangle is this guy right here. This time, taking a look at so this is a standing up triangle right here. But if we take a look at a lying down triangle, I'm going to do this with pencil so that I can erase it. If you take a look at the lying down triangle that's formed right here, this would be, I'll erase it and put it in green. Okay, so again, this is the standing up triangle, but this green triangle right here that I'm drawing, this is a lying down triangle. And if I draw this lying down triangle, what I'm going to have is this side is equal to x. This right here is the one that I'm looking for. This guy right here. And I know that from the hypotenuse of this triangle, well, that's simply the radius of the circular base. So this is r. So that means this guy, this side right here, has to equal the square root of r squared minus x squared. Okay, so that's this part right here. And so then the base of the rectangle, this one, is just twice that amount. So this guy is going to be 2 times the square root of r squared minus x squared. And that's it. That's my cross section. So now I can find a formula for the area of the cross section. The area is equal to, so the area with respect to x is equal to the base times the height. Well, the height we just talked about it. The height is equal to x. That's this one right here. So 2x times the square root of r squared minus x squared. Okay, so then the integral that I'm looking for to find the volume is going to be the volume is going to be the integral from 0 to r, because I'm going from here from 0 until the very end, which is when x is equal to r, the radius of the area, which is 2x square root of r squared minus x squared dx. And that's my setup. And so now all I have to do is evaluate this integral. So I'm going to use substitution because I notice that the derivative of the inside here, r squared minus x squared, is outside of here. So du would be negative 2x dx. And so if I add in a negative here on the inside and a negative on the outside, I would have that negative 2x dx is equal to du. And then I can substitute u in for r squared minus x squared. Okay, and then all I need to do is change the limits of integration. So if x is equal to 0, u is going to equal r squared. And if x is equal to r, then u is going to equal 0. Okay. So this is the volume is then equal to minus the integral from r squared to 0 of square root of u du. And then actually I'm better off using the properties of integration. I can switch this from 0 to r squared by switching the sign on the outside, and so the negative on the outside would turn into a positive. And then let me change that to u to the 1/2 du. Okay, and so then what I have is the antiderivative is u to the 3/2 times the reciprocal, which is 2/3. And this is going to be evaluated from 0 to r squared. Okay, and so let's plug it in. So here what I have then is 2/3. If I plug in r squared, I would end up with r to the 3rd. Minus, if I plug in 0, I would just get 0. And so this is the answer in the end.